Hey, this is Puneet back again, and in this video we are looking at three date functions that we can use in VBA and that can be super useful for you while working with VBA in Excel. So the first function that we are looking into is FileDateTime. You can use this function to know that when a file was last modified, on which date and at which time. So when you enter the function name, you need to enter a starting parenthesis, and then you need to define the path of that particular file. So I have this mp3 file on my desktop, so I'm going to get the location path of this file, and now I'm going to enter this, so with double quotation marks, and then the path of the file, again double quotation marks, and then closing the parenthesis. And to get the result of this function, I'm going to use the cell A1. Now let's run this code. So it gives me 3rd of October 2021 and afternoon 3:15. So let me go to the desktop again and check the actual date and time on the modification, last modification. So it is 3rd of October 2021, afternoon 3:15. So the result we're getting with this function is correct. So the point is, you can get date and time of last modification of any file that you have in your system. Now the second function that we're looking into is date function. And date function is one of the most useful function that we have in VBA library. So with date function, we can get the current date. So let's say if I want to insert current date into the cell A1, I simply need to use the date function, and there is no argument that you need to define. So simply need to enter date. Yes, that's it. So when I run this code, it gives me the current date according to the date that I have in my system, and insert it into the cell A1. And if you want to get date in a specific format other than the default format that we have in Excel, you can use format function along with the date function. So it will go something like this: format, and then date, and then you need to define the format in which you want to enter the date into the cell. And now if I run this code, so it gives me the current date, but as per the format that I have specified in the format function. Alright, so the next function that we have is DateAdd function, and this function can be super useful for you. So with the help of this function, you can add a interval into a specific date. So let's say we have this 5 October 2021 in cell A2, and if I want to add 5 years in this date, I can use DateAdd function to do that. And in the same way, I can add months, days, or even I can add time like hours, minutes and seconds. So let's say if I want to add 5 years into this 5 October 2021, so I'm going to use DateAdd. And then I need to define the interval that I want to add. That's the format that I need to specify. And then I need to define the number, that how many intervals I want to add. So if I want to add 5 years, I need to specify 5. And then the date. So for this, I'm going to use date to get the current date. So this is the same function that we have learned earlier. And now if I run this code, so it gives me 5 October 2026. So it's 5 years into 2021. And in the same way, if you want to add months, so here I will use only M. I want to add, 6 months. And if I run this code, it gives me 5th of April 2022. So now we are into October. So November, December, January, February, March, and April. 5th of April. So here we have few strings to specify interval that we want to add into the date. So you can use days, hours, minutes, months, even quarters, seconds, weeks, and years. Alright, so that's it for this video. I hope you found this video useful, and make sure to subscribe to this channel because I'll be coming out with a lot of cool VBA tutorials in coming weeks. And I'll see you next week.